band's name is like the title of the article. It's underlined, making it seem more important. It also lets the reader know who the band are. For someone who's never heard of them or has never seen them before, it makes it obvious who the article is about. The drop capital in the middle of the page gives the article a sense of character. It makes it stand out and look different to what most magazine articles look like nowadays. It gives the page a bit of colour, which would be missing as it would be all black and white with no wow factor. The Times New Roman font works well within the magazine as a whole. It gives it the quirky look the magazine seems to want to put across. The mashup of pictures gives the reader an insight to what the band are like on a more personal level and give the reader more of an opportunity to see them having a laugh together. The collage of pictures show the band behind the scenes having a laugh together, but also show the band doing what everyone else sees, them on stage performing their music, which gives the audience a contrast of pictures. The layout of the column is very standard to what you would see in most magazines. The names of the people speaking are in bold to make it obvious, and the layout is well presented to look professional. There are more drop capitals than usual, but I think that works well with the magazine's image of being a little different. The little box in the middle of the pictures explains to the reader what each one of the photos are and where they were took. This is a good feature to have in a magazine, as it gives the reader a little more information about the photos and where they have come from, making it more informative. For example, stating which band member is being photographed.